Hello and welcome to Bungay Castle. My name is Peter Tryon. 20 years ago I was taking a lesson at school, a geography lesson, and the pupils had to identify places from six-figure grid references. One of the places that I discovered was Great Ashfield, which is just north of Elmswell in the centre of Suffolk. To my surprise, I discovered there was a castle there. I then proceeded to ask somebody who lived in the village, and they knew nothing about the castle at all. But while I was looking up information, I discovered there was also a castle here at Bungay, and there was a castle at Clare. And from then on, I suppose, the idea for the book started. Now, we're standing here at the moment in Bungay Castle, which was one of Bigod's castle, built in 1103. Behind me is the Barbican. The Barbican, as you can see, has two towers. In between them would have been a portcullis. This was to trap invaders inside the inner bailey, and then no doubt they would have actually sent down hot sand from the tower roof. Now, they didn't use boiling oil because it was far too expensive. So what they used instead was hot sand. So when the attackers looked up, they were blinded by the hot sand. And also you can imagine what hot sand was like inside your armour. It was pretty, pretty uncomfortable. This castle was in fact attacked twice. First of all by King Stephen, and second by Henry II. Henry II ordered that the castle should be razed to the ground. As you can see, the job wasn't done very well, and we are very grateful for this now, because what it gives us is a really interesting insight into what this castle looked like originally. Originally, it would have had a fine keep, probably the same size as Castle Hellingham or Rochester, and it must have been a really imposing and magnificent building in the town. No doubt the people of the town were stood in awe and wonder at the magnificence of the Bigod family and the owners of Bungay Castle. I hope you enjoy the book.